believe, because this is where the people are. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord that we're able to preach the gospel to you, because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of God. If God didn't send out his messengers today, you probably wouldn't even think about God. And the Bible says that God is in none of the thoughts of the wicked. We want you to be reconciled unto the Father. We want you to come to Jesus. We want you to receive mercy and forgiveness for your sins. But a fool rages on in his self-confidence. You take this proud countenance and you shake your fist in the face of God. You think you're going to tell God how it is on the day of judgment? You're gravely mistaken. Gravely. God is creator. God has revealed himself to all people. The fool says in his heart that there is no God. You know that you're going to be accountable to God for one day for your actions. You're going to be accountable to God one day for the way that you're dressing today. Letting everything hang out, looking cheap. You know, when you reduce the amount of clothing that's on your body, that's like taking an item in a store and putting a sticker on it saying, reduced, clearance, it's cheap, it's not worth much. And that's what you do. When you don't wear a lot of clothes, you cheapen yourself. God's not pleased with that. God wants you to be a holy woman. God wants you to be a woman of honor. And when you cheapen yourself, you're not a woman of honor. You're something that's common. It's cheap. There's a lot of women that expose their body. You're not special when you expose your body. You're just provoking pride in your life. You're causing other people to sin. You're causing the wrath of God to be upon other people's lives. And you should be concerned about that, because you're going to be responsible for that in the end. You are putting a stumbling block in front of men. You're putting a stumbling block in front of people dressing like that. It's wicked. It's wicked for women to expose their breasts. It's wicked for women to expose their body. It's cheap. Come to God. You know, in the Bible, the word of God says that I desire, therefore, that men pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands without wrath and doubting. And in like manner, that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with moderation and propriety. Not with braided hair, nor gold, or pearls, or costly clothing, but that which is proper for women professing godliness with good works. For women professing godliness with good works, that means the Bible says that you are to dress modestly, that it's the hidden beauty of a woman. It's a hidden beauty that people see. People don't look at the outside and they're attracted to that. People are attracted to the spirit that's within you. And if you have a disgusting, dirty spirit, a wicked spirit inside of you, there's no drawing to you except the drawing from the evil ones, the drawing from Satan. But when you have the Spirit of God in you, there is an attractiveness, because the beauty of God manifests in your life. It manifests in your speech. It manifests in the way that you conduct yourself. Proverbs 31 says, who can find a virtuous wife? For her worth is far above women. The heart of her husband safely dressed her, so he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and willingly works with her hands. She is like the merchant's ships. She brings her food from afar. She also rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and a portion for her maidservants. She considers a field and buys it. From her profits, she plants a vineyard. She girds herself with strength and strengthens her arms. She perceives that her merchandise is good, and her lamp does not go out by night. She stretches out her hands to the distaff, and her hand holds the spindle. She extends her hands to the poor. Yes, she reaches out her hand to the needy. She is not afraid of snow for her household, for all her household is clothed with scarlet. She makes tapestry for herself. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. Her husband is known in the gates when he sits among the elders of the land. She makes linen and garments and sells them and supplies sashes for the merchants. Strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the wrath of kindness. She watches over all the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praises her. Many daughters have done well, but you excel them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is passing, but a woman who fears the Lord, she shall be praised. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gate. That's what the Bible says, that a woman should measure her standards up against. Not against the ways of the world, not against Hollywood, not against the cheap things of this world. God says that you are to measure yourself according to the ways of the Holy Word in the Bible. You are to measure yourself. You are to examine yourself as to whether you are in the faith. Test yourself. Do you not know that the evil child is in you? And that indeed you are disqualified.
Come back to your first one. You need a fear of the Lord and depart from it.
evil. Don't think that your angel is going to save you from this or that. Oh, it's the Lord. It's the Lord that has mercy upon your life that saves you from destruction. And maybe the Lord has had mercy upon your life up to this point because he wants you to be reconciled, because he wants you to repent. But who knows when the arm of the Lord will be drawn back and he will deliver you. He will deliver you into your uncleanness, into your sin. You know, that there's a point with God where he will cut you off. And you will be a captive. You will be a reprobate. You need a fear of the Lord. That don't be drawn away by all this distraction, all this wickedness. God, Jesus Christ is calling you today to repentance. Jesus Christ is calling you today to repentance. When Annas and Caiaphas were high priests, the word of God came to John, the son of Zacharias, in the wilderness. And he went into all the region around the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance. You need the baptism of repentance. As it is written in the book of Isaiah the prophet, the voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. And every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill brought low. The crooked places made straight, and the rough ways smooth. And all flesh shall see the salvation of God. When you cry out to God, you repent for your sins. You see what destruction has happened for your sin. You see that your soul is going to be destroyed in hell. It's going to be tortured in hell. And you cry out to God for mercy. That's repentance. That's seeking Jesus. It's not repentance by confessing your sin to a priest. That's not in the Bible. God wants you to come to Jesus. God the Father is calling you through his Son, Jesus. In the Bible says that you cannot come to God unless the Father first draws you. And we pray for you. We pray that you would have ears to hear. We pray for you that you would receive these words which are spirit. God says that the word. A little while longer, the light is with you. Walk in the light while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. He who is in darkness does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light that you may become sons of light. Believe in Jesus. Jesus is the light. You're not living a life of belief right now. You're being an unbeliever. You're being a sinner right now. You're being a sinner right now, and that's shameful. God does not look favorably upon your life right now. Look at yourself in the mirror. Look at yourself in the mirror. You don't look like a godly person. You look like someone that is on the broad road that leads to hell. That's what you look like right now. Look in the mirror. I don't have to say this to you. You should already know it when you look at yourself in the mirror, exposing your body, being all drunk. You probably, some of you can't even probably see straight because you're so drunk right now. Oh, God wants you to sober up. God wants you to awake you to sleep, arise from the dead, and Christ will give you life. Jesus wants to give you life. You can have everlasting life. For Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And no man comes to the Father. No man comes to the Father except for Jesus Christ alone. You can't come to Father God without Jesus. Jesus said that all things have been delivered to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father. Nor does anyone know the Father but the Son, and the one to whom the Son wills to reveal him. And then Jesus says, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus wants to give you rest for your souls. Jesus wants to give you rest for your souls. He says, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. You'll find rest for your souls in Jesus. You won't find rest for your souls in the world. You won't find rest for your souls in your beer and your intoxication. You won't find rest for your souls in your sexual morality. Oh, you know what the Bible says, that unless people commit wickedness, that their rest to find it in a boyfriend. You're not going to find it in a girlfriend. You're not going to find it in your careers. You're only going to find rest for your souls in Jesus Christ. He wants to redeem you from death. Don't be a fornicator. Don't have sex outside of marriage. God wants to please you and bring you to a place of honor. You know, that the Bible says that the marriage bed is honorable. It's honorable for a man and a woman to come together in marriage. In marriage. But the adulterer and the fornicator, God's going to judge that person. Sex outside of marriage is fornication. And that leads to hell. If you're having sex outside of marriage, you're on your way to hell. God wants you to be someone that's honorable. I mean, it's logical that people that have sex outside of marriage it's sinful, it's gross, it's disgusting, it's unholy. It's just logical. When you think of someone that's a holy woman, you don't think of a holy woman sleeping around, exposing her body, smoking cigarettes, doing drugs, having a defiled mouth. That's not holy. I mean, that's just logical. That's just common sense. But God is able to redeem you. As long as God's able to redeem your life, God redeemed my life because I was the sexually immoral woman. I was the one that had a terrible mouth. I didn't even know how to properly love my husband until the Lord taught me how to properly love my husband. Because sinners are selfish. Sinners just want to be satisfied. Sinners just want me. And that's why the divorce rate is so high, because people are sinful. People are sinful. They're in their sin when they are committing divorce. They're in their sin because there's adultery presence within their marriage, or they just don't like the other person. There is some manifestation of sin when you have divorce, and God hates divorce. God hates divorce. What about being long-suffering with your spouse? What about the promise that you made to God and in front of your friends and family on the day that you got married? When you said, I will love this person and I'm going to be long-suffering. What about the fruit of the Spirit? What about the fruit of the Spirit? Being long-suffering, demonstrating self-control, respecting your husband. What happened to women respecting your husbands? Don't follow the ways of the world. The TV teaches you that woman is the head of the household, and that's wicked. That's not what God says. God says the man is the head of the household. The man. And women are to submit to their husbands. Women are to obey and be respectful to their husbands. Not to be the head of the household, not to make the decisions in the house. Lesbian marriages are not honored by God. Homosexual marriages between man and man is not honored before God. That is the stuff that leads you to hell. But some people have come out of homosexuality. Just like in 1 Corinthians 6:9, what it talks about. The homosexual and how that leads to hell. And then it gives a long laundry list of sins, and it says, and such is some of you, but you are lost, but you are sanctified, but you are justified in the name of our Lord Jesus